She is Australia's favourite showgirl and one of Studio 10's most popular guest hosts. But what is life like for Carlotta when all the feathers and sparkles come off? Our very own Craig Bennett has an exclusive tour through her life and home.
Let's get it right this time. Okay, music.
Action.
We love Carlotta on Studio 10. She's part of our family. She's glitzy, she's glamorous, one of Australia's favourite showgirls. But at home, she's Carol. And guess what? We've copped an invite to lunch. Let's go and have a chat to Carol and get to know the Carlotta you maybe don't know. Place is just alive with colour and razzle dazzle.
Do you know what? It's my home. It's not extravagant. I've got all the pieces in here I love. That's the main thing, you know, my paintings. I paint a bit myself.
Alive with colour, glitz and glamour, just like our darling Carlotta. It's hard to imagine she's in her 70s.
I'm 72 in September. Have you got that Studio 10 studio? I want a cake.
And what would you like to pop out of the middle of it?
Me and Joe.
It wasn't long into our tour to Carlotta that we were reminded of just what Carol had been through.
How did you feel about the headlines around Caitlyn Jenner's transitioning and to think that you did that back in the 70s?
Well, you know, she's one lucky person because she's got all the support around her. Like when I did number 96, they locked me away in a cabinet.
Take me back to the beginning of number 96 because you created a sensation on that show.
Well, they said, we'd like you to do number 96. I said, I can't act. I said, I'm a showgirl.
Honey, now listen to me first. There's something about me you have to know.
They didn't know how to finish it. They said, how are we going to reveal? They wanted me to stand up in a bathtub and I said, there's no way. I still had my dilly lily in those days. And I said, no friggin' way, I'm a lady, get over it.
There isn't a particle of you that I don't love or want or remember.
Next minute we had him trying to attack me on the lounge and kiss me and everything, and his hand goes up my dress. And he goes, oh, Miss Ross, I mean, Mr. Ross.
I'm not a girl, but you said you'd guessed.
I had guessed nothing of the sort. Miss Ross. Mr. Ross?
Well, that hit the headlines the next day. I knew what I wanted. I went to the doctors, I went to them, I changed their system in a way because they were just so wrong.
Had shock therapy.
Yeah,
just
tell me, just stupid things. You know, they really, because it was experimental.
A traumatic experience it was, but whatever happened to life before Carol?
Photographs of you as Richard, nobody gets to see those. Why is that?
Well, I don't, you know, people have probably got shots out there. It's just that he's gone.
But not everyone in Carlotta's life was happy with the transition.
My mother never accepted it.
Really? Do you think if it was now Carol, it would be different? Or do you
Well, it is different.
Do you think she'd be more accepting if everything was spooled forward to where we are now, or maybe not?
I don't know. You know, there are some... It's a very hard thing for a mother to accept. That's the way I live my life. And if people don't like it, you know, they can blow it you know where. Take me for what I am. And, of course, this is the art gallery. This is when I was doing the kitchen show, you know, that cooking thing.
I do.
And then they wanted these shots up with me. That's a good weekender I did. Oh, and this is the boudoir, darling. I said, oh, my God.
Well, it's very cosy. I never thought I'd find my way into Carlotta's bedroom,
it's
but now
Marie,
I have.
It's my luxury. Take me, baby,
But not only did we get a tour through the private life of Carol, we're also treated to a luscious lunch as well.
So what are we doing today?
I'm doing garlic prawns for you.
It will be fabulous.
And then I've got a beautiful cake for you.
Do you? You think I need fattening up?
No.
What
Cheers,
an absolute
darling.
Joy to be at yours for lunch, I have to say. You know what? With a glass of wine comes a little gossip. and I'm going to be cheeky here.
Right.
A friend of yours with a very big mouth, and you probably know who I'm talking about.
Right, yes. I've got a few of them, actually.
Well, she whispered into my shell-like ear, and you know, I just can't keep a secret. It's shocking, it's scandalous, but it's quite true, that you at one point in time had a torrid, long, very hot, passionate affair with an Australian TV legend. Is this true or not?
Yes, it is true. And not only a TV legend, but a few people through the industry. But
will you ever reveal? Will you ever?
No, 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 darling, that goes to my grave.
You never kiss him?
No, because if I get to the other side, I might meet up with him again. Oh, and I'll be happy, Jan.
Really? So he was a good lover, was he?
The best.
Really?
Mm.
Carlotta.
I know, I'm naughty, aren't I? Do you know what? He gave me the uttermost respect. And that's why, if he'd have been an arsehole or a bastard, I would have revealed it.
A salacious, scandalous shocker lover, but there was no getting through those tight lips.
Bon appetit.
Bon appetit. Carlotta. Cheers, fabulous. Darling, and thank you
Cheers.
For coming.
Right. What a cheer. Take me back.
I love her to death,
but God, that's jaw-dropping.
She's just fabulous. She's the best woman. I just
There's
love her
There's something about her, just everything that comes out of her mouth is just completely true. Like, everyone just goes, yeah, that's right.
Yeah.